Hello students, welcome back. In the last session we have discussed tables, creating a table and displaying content in a table. In today's session we will discuss forms in XHTML. Forms in general, if you see, are the way by which we can enter information. You might get a form when you go for admission in the college, where you fill all your details and you submit the form. Similar way, we can submit certain forms online as well. Even you might have come across such forms when you go online. For example, you are creating an account on a Gmail or Google. You have to submit your details first, and these details are submitted in the forms, by using forms. So how those forms are created, how we can submit the information, that we will study today. So forms in XHTML or forms in on web can be created by using a tag called as form. Okay, so we'll study about it. Let's start. Forms is a usual way information is gotten from a browser to a server. So forms are a usual way by which you can get information from a browser and you can send it to the server. So information is retrieved from the browser or from a user, and this information is sent to the server. HTML has tags to create a collection of objects that implement this information gathering. So HTML or XHTML provides us with number of tags for getting the information or collecting the information from the user, and these objects are called as widgets in HTML. So the objects which are used to collect information are called as widgets in HTML. Remember this. We have used widgets in other languages also. In Android also we have used widgets. We have used widgets in Python. We have used widgets in Java as well. In Java we call it as components. So these widgets can be used to collect information from the HTML file. Okay, the widgets, for example, radio buttons, checkboxes, the same set of widgets which we have used in other languages as well. When the submit button of a form is clicked, the form's values are sent to the server. So form also contains a button called a submit button, and upon clicking on that submit button, the values from these widgets are automatically sent to the server. All the widgets or components of a form are defined in the content of form tag. So all the widgets needs to be declared inside the form tag. So how to create a form in HTML? Use a form tag, and there is a open tag and a close tag, separate open and close tag. Inside the open and close form tag, we need to have all the widgets which are used to collect information. Now the form tag has some attributes, and one only required attribute of the form tag is the attribute action. Action is the attribute of a form tag which is a required attribute, and this specifies the URL, that is universal resource locator, of the application that is to be called when the submit button is clicked. So what is this URL? This is the address of an application to which the data has to be sent. Okay, for example, it is given here, action is equals to http://www.cs.upsc.edu/survey.pl. So we are sending data to this application whenever a submit button is called. So that is the purpose of using action. It simply gives you an address where the data has to be sent. If the form has no action, if no action attribute is specified, automatically the value of action is set to empty string. So no value. Okay. There's one more attribute of the form tag. The attribute is method attribute. And this method attribute of form specifies one of the two possible techniques of transferring the form data to the server. These techniques are get and post. So method here specifies the way by which the data has to be transmitted. Generally, there are two different ways in which the data is sent to the server. One is by get method, another by using post method. So there is a difference in using get and post. In case of get, the data is sent in the URL itself, whereas in case of post, the data is sent in the request heading. So get is faster, post you can say a bit slower, but post is more secure than the get, because get method displays data in the URL itself. So it is less secure, and we can send only limited amount of data when we are using a get method. In case of post method, we can send unlimited data to the server. Generally, when no method is specified, no method attribute is specified, by default it is set to get. Okay, so that is about a form. And form contains widgets, I said. So there are many different widgets which we can create, and many of these widgets are created by using a tag called as input tag. So input tag is used to create many of the different widgets. Now input tag contains one attribute called as type attribute. This specifies kind of widgets being created. What type of widget is created, that is based on the type attribute. Now let us see a widget that is text widget. I want to create something like a text box in HTML or XHTML. Then how it can be created? It can be created by specifying the value of type as text. What it creates? It creates a horizontal box for text input. It creates a horizontal box like this, where you can enter text. Okay, the default size of this box is 20, means 20 characters are visible by default, and it can be changed by using an attribute called as size. If more characters are entered than will fit, the box is scrolled, that is shifted to the left. By default the size is 20. If I am entering more than 20 characters, the box is automatically shifted to the left. The characters are shifted to the left, but still you can type the characters, any number of characters, but only the visible area is of 20 characters. Remember, if you don't want to allow user to type more characters than will fit, set maximum length. Now there is one more important attribute here, max length. If you don't want user to enter more than 20 characters or more than 15 characters, say, then you can set max length to 15 or max length to 20, so that user cannot enter more than 15 or 20 characters. Okay, how to create this text field? Here is an example. Input type is equals to text. This will create a text field or text box. Name is equals to phone. Again, every widget can have a ID or name attribute. So name here it is phone. Size here it is 20. Sorry, size is 12. By default it is 20 when not specified, but we have specified here that is 12. So size of that text field will be of 12. Okay, so this is how we can create a text field or a text box in HTML. Let me show you this with an example. Okay, let us open a notepad plus. Okay, I'll create a new file itself. I'll use HTML rather than XHTML. For XHTML, you have to add the XML declaration doc type and XMLNS attribute inside HTML tag. But for now, I will be using HTML. Okay, inside the body, how to declare a form tag? It is simply form, and one required attribute is action, which is equals to the URL, the address to which you want to send the data. Right now, I don't want to send any data to a particular address, so I'll just keep it blank. There's one more attribute called as method, which is also optional, but you can specify it. The two methods, two values can be used, that is get or post. Get sends the data in the URL, post in the header. So we have form open and form close. Inside the form open and form close, we have to specify our widgets, or we have to create our widgets so that the data from the widgets is captured by the form. If you declare any widgets outside the form, the data from those widgets will not be captured by the form tag, remember, and that data will not be sent to the URL. Only if the widgets are declared inside the form, the data is captured from it and it is sent to the server. Okay, so we will see how to create a text widget. To create a text widget, as I've said, there is a tag called as input, and the type of input has to be text. Okay, I'll declare only this much for now. We'll just verify it. Okay, so we have created input text. I'll save it. I'll say text demo dot html and save it. The file is saved, so let me open and show you the output. Okay, you can see this is our output, and you will have a text box like this where you can enter the data. By default, the size is 20. If you try to enter more characters in that, more than 20, it will automatically scroll to the left. You can see it is scrolling to the left. Still, I am able to enter the characters. And the size can be changed by using an attribute here. The attribute is size is equals to, if I say size as 3, you can see there, if I go back and refresh, the size has changed. Okay. But even though the size is 3, you can enter more than more characters into it. More characters into it. As you are entering the character, it is scrolling to the left. If you don't want more characters to be entered, then you can set one more attribute, that is max length attribute. Max length is equals to, if I say 3, max length is equals to 3. Now, okay, you can see I am still typing a character here, but that is not printed in the text box because the maximum length is 3. So you cannot type more than 3 characters if the max length attribute is set. So this is how you can create a text widget in the XHTML. With this, we will stop here today. Thank you.